The solid rocket booster hydraulic units are activated. The countdown now being conducted by the onboard computers with the ground computer acting as backup. T-minus 15, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We have a go for main engine start. We have main engine start. All three engines are up and running. Beautiful engine going here. We have a gimbling of those engines. We gimbal them sequentially with 1, 2, and 3. And we have had shutdown. We have had shutdown of all three engines. A full 20 second burn as expected.
T-minus 40 seconds, SRB development flight recorders are being turned on. T-minus 37, gaseous oxygen vent arm will not be retracted on this particular test. T-minus 31 seconds, we have a go from LPS for auto sequence start. Four primary flight computers taking over main control of the terminal count. Final LPS command for engine start will occur at approximately T-minus 10 seconds. T-minus 15 seconds and counting. T-minus 10, go for main engine start. Hydrogen burn igniters are, we have engine start on the first main engine. Zero, T-minus zero, engines throttled at 100%, all three engines up and burning. T-plus 5 seconds, engine continuing to burn. T-plus 10 seconds, 12. First cutoff, T-plus 15 seconds, engine cutoff. And engines 2 and 3 also cut off at T-plus 16.8 seconds. T-plus 25 seconds. GLS safing now in progress. We are continuing to run the APUs. We'll now turn them on to high speed for approximately a minute and a half high speed run. APU high speed is verified, T plus 45 seconds. T plus 1 minute, APU is continuing to run. They'll run for approximately the T plus 2 minute mark. T plus 1 minute, 25 seconds. Continuing with the test of the orbiter auxiliary power units into the plus time. Verifying those units are go for flight. T plus 1 minute, 45 seconds. T plus 2 minutes. The GLS critical safing has been completed. And we have shut down the all three of the orbiter auxiliary power units. This basically completes the flight readiness firing. There are still a number of hours of safing operations yet to be completed. We do have to drain the liquid oxygen, liquid hydrogen propellants out of the external tank. But other than that, the test appeared to have gone very successfully. The engines were run at the proper levels, engine number one being cut off at 15 seconds, engines two and three simultaneously being cut off at 16.8 seconds as planned.
Hydrogen leak on the new Space Shuttle Challenger. That's the late word from Cape Canaveral, where the three main engines of the Challenger were tested again today.
Nine. We have a go for main engine start. Six, we have main engine start. All three engines are up and running. So 20 minutes
22nd firing. We have approximately 7 more seconds remaining. At 100% thrust. And we have shutdown. We have shutdown on time.
Results of today's test mean another delay in the first flight of the Challenger, possibly a delay until late summer.
On. T-minus 33 seconds and counting. Gaseous oxygen vent arm is retracted. 28 seconds. We're now on flight or orbiter control. The final command for engine start will occur at approximately T-minus 10 seconds. T-minus 20 seconds now. Preparing to enter the final sequence, T-minus 15. T-minus 10, 9, 8, firing, 7, main engine start sequence. We have main engine start. We have 3 engines up and running. T-0. T-plus 5 seconds. T-plus 10 seconds. T-plus 11, shutdown of number 1 engine. T-plus 13 seconds, shutdown of engines number 2 and 3. All 3 engines have shut down. The shutdown sequence appears to have been normal here on the firing room television. We're continuing with the high-speed APU run at this point, T-plus 24 seconds.
Sheila shows engine 1, 2, 3, shutdown.
Copy, GLS. T-plus 30 seconds, the APU high-speed performance.
Shutdown, engine 1, 2, 3.
GLS, go for APU high-speed.
APU, perform APU high-speed run and shutdown. Report completion. APU
copies. We're on high speed now.
High speed run of the APUs is now in progress. That'll continue for about another 1 minute. At this point, the ground launch sequencer automatically safes the vehicle while this run is being completed and returns it to a safe condition.
Coming up on auto sequence start. We have a go for auto sequence start. Atlantis is on board computers now controlling the final sequence. Minus 15 seconds. Minus 12. Go for main engine start. Minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have 3 engines up. All going well. Cut off command should be issued at this time. Our flight readiness firing is completed. All 3 engines came up. We ran for the full planned duration of this test. All preliminary indications would be we had a completely successful test this morning.
T-minus 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. We have a go for main engine start. 7, 6. We have main engine start. The motor is up and running. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Plus 10 seconds, 11. 12, we have a go for a shutdown, and we have safing in progress. If the computer had failed to command the shutdown on time, there were a number of safeguards built into the system.
One and two are showing post shutdown, and also engine 3.
T-minus 31 seconds.
Go for auto sequence start.
Endeavor's 4 redundant computers have primary control of critical vehicle functions for the remainder of the count. T-minus 20 seconds. Sound suppression water will be released on the launch platform. T-minus 12, 11, 10. 9. We have a go for engine start. 6. 5. We have main engine start. 2. 1. 0. Engines are now at 100% of rated power. 5. Plus 6. Plus 7. Plus 10. Plus 11. Plus 14. And we have an abort. And everything occurred according to plan today. Safing operations are underway.
Engines 1, 2, and 3 are now showing post-shutdown standby, and we are go for orbiter APU shutdown.
Copy.
No MPS fire detectors tipped at this time.
And the abort is planned as normal for a flight readiness firing to shut down the main engines.
Hydrogen, please.